I think it's every kid's dream to own a toy shop. It's your favorite place in the whole world. So many things to play with, so many worlds you could go to in your imagination. The opportunities are truly endless. So if you had a toy shop, what would you put in it? This is My Own Toy Shop, which was designed by Evgeny Nikitin and published by Lifestyle Board Games, who helped sponsor this video. Hi everybody, my name is Nick Murphy of the Brothers Murph, and we are here with BoardGameGeek.com. Well, I know my toy shop will have all of the teddy bears, but before I can build it, let's get this game down to the table to go a little more in focus on My Own Toy Shop. My Own Toy Shop is a tile-laying game for kids 6 and up where players will be building out their toy shops and trying to collect the different types of toys. The game will start with every player having a cash register and will end once all players have made a 4x4 toy shop. All the toy tiles will be in a face-down stack and 4 tiles will be placed face-up on the table. On their turn, a player will simply take one of the face-up tiles and place it in their toy shop. The tiles must be placed adjacent to another tile in their shop. They may not be placed off-center like this, or on a corner, and they may not be rotated. Players will want to try and match toys in their shop to gain money. The toy types are represented by the colors and the patterns of the background. The blue backgrounds are plush toys, red are vehicles, purple are dolls, and green are sports toys. When placing a tile, the player will gain money for how many toys are in matching color areas. For example, if the player placed this tile here, they matched blue and red. They will then count the number of toys in each color area and gain that many coins. So in this example, the player will gain 3 coins for blue and 4 for red. The cash register has no toys on it and therefore won't give the players any coins, but it has all 4 colors on it, which makes it great for matching. Players track their money on the coin track, and every time they make 10 coins, they take a $10 note. Naturally, you want to have lots of different toys because kids like all sorts of different things, but it's also very beneficial for your shop to be known for one kind of toy. Each kind of toy has 5 different variations. For example, the plush toys have a cat, a dog, a bunny, a bear, and a unicorn. And there's a race to get all 5. The first player to collect all 5 of a certain kind of toy gets the related reward. These are difficult to get as they're worth 5 points, and so everyone is racing to claim them. Play will continue until all players have a 4x4 grid of tiles in their toy shop. Then the game will end. Players will then collect majority rewards. Players will see who has the most of one kind of toy in each category. For instance, if at the end of the game, player 1 has 4 fire trucks and player 2 has 6 trains, player 2 wins the reward because they have the most of one type of toy in a category of toys, in this case, in the vehicle category. Once majorities have been rewarded, the players count all of their coins and rewards, and the player with the most coins will win. This game is super cute and has a theme that pretty much every child can get behind. Running your own toy shop sounds awesome. But behind the theme is an easy to learn tile laying game that has some impactful choices. Players have to balance between making color groups for coins while trying to chase those rewards. It's not complicated, but they are legitimate decisions that have to be made. And if My Own Toy Shop seems like a game you'd enjoy, make sure to check out its page on BoardGameGeek.com to learn more. And until next time, I've been Nick Murphy. We're here with Board Game Geek, and we've been going in focus on My Own Toy Shop. Have a great day.